Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the last class, we had started with the chapter multiples and factors, correct? So we studied what are multiples in the last class, and today's class we will study what are factors. So first let's see what we did in the last class. Multiples. What are multiples? When we multiply any number by counting numbers, we get the multiples of that number. So what are counting numbers? Numbers from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on are called as counting numbers. Since counting numbers are endless or indefinite, multiple of a number also will be indefinite. Okay, so when you multiply any number with the counting numbers, you get the multiples of that number. Then the smallest of the common multiples is called as the lowest common multiple or LCM. So when you have two numbers and you have written down the multiples of both of them, and what you can do is you can find the common multiples among those numbers, and then whichever is the least will be the lowest common multiple, which is called as LCM, right? So we studied what are the properties of multiples. So first property is every number is a multiple of itself. Okay, so for example, 5, when you multiply 5 with 1, we get 5 only, correct? 5 ones are 5. So 5 is a multiple of itself. So same way, all the numbers, every number is a multiple of itself. Then every number is a multiple of 1. Now if you see one table, we know that 1 ones are 1, 1 twos are 2, right? So every number will be a multiple of 1. Any number it is, it will be a multiple of 1. Then all multiples of a number are greater than or equal to the number itself. So multiples, when you're writing, you have to remember that a multiple will not be smaller than the given number. All multiples of a number are greater than that number or equal to the number itself. Okay, other than 0, which is a multiple of every number. 0 is a multiple of every number, it will be smaller than the given numbers. Then there are countless multiples of numbers. Since there are countless counting numbers, the multiples of a number also will be countless. So these are the few properties of multiples. Then we saw how to find multiples, correct? So here they have to list the 6 multiples of 8 and 12. So you have to write first 6 multiples of 8 and 12. So what you will do, first you will multiply 8 with 1. So 8 ones are 1, 8 twos are 16, 8 threes are 24, 8 fours are 32, 8 fives are 40, and 8 sixes are 48. Then to find multiples of 12, we'll multiply 12 ones are 12, 12 twos are 24, 12 threes are 36, 12 fours are 48, 12 fives are 60, and 12 sixes are 72. So in these two, what are the common multiples? 24 are there in both, and 48 are common, correct? So common multiples are 24 and 48, and the lowest common multiple, that is LCM, is 24, because 24 is the smallest among 24 and 48. So LCM of 8 and 12 is 24. Okay, so then check whether 1278 is a multiple of 9. So to check if that number is a multiple of 9, what you have to do? You have to find if it is divisible by 9. So what is the divisibility rule for 9? Sum of the digits should be divisible by 9. So here sum of the digits is 18, which is divisible by 9. That's why 1278 is a multiple of 9. Okay, so then here they have to list the multiples of 7 between 40 and 50. So what you will do, you will write the 7 times table and see which multiples come between 40 and 50. So here we have 42 and 49, which come between 40 and 50. Okay, so this is all about multiples that we have studied in the last class. Then we did exercise 4.1 and the problems that were given in that, correct? Today, let's start with today's topic now, that is factors. So what are factors? So you just saw that multiples of a number which are obtained by multiplying a number by 1, 2, 3 and so on. So now if we consider the number 20, we know that 1 20s is 20, then 2 10s is also 20, 4 5s is also 20. So what you see, 20 is a multiple of 1, 2, 4, 5, 10 and 20 itself.
correct? So these numbers, that is 1, 2, 4, 5, 10, and 20, are called the factors of 20. So factors of a number are those numbers that exactly divide the given number. So here, 20 can be divided by 1, 2, 4, 5, and 10 exactly, and 20 also, without leaving any remainder. So factors are those numbers that exactly divide the given numbers with the remainder of 0. So writing a number as a product of its factors is called as factorization. We have written here, right? 1 into 20 is 20, 2 into 10, 20, 4 into 5, 20. So here we are writing it as a product of two factors. So 1 is one factor, 20 is one factor. And when you put a multiplication sign, it becomes product of two factors. So this is called as factorization. Alright. So there are a few properties of factors. What are the different properties of factors? First is, 1 is a factor of every number. Okay, 1 is a factor of every number. Just the same way how every 1 is a multiple of every number is a multiple of 1, the same way 1 is a factor of every number. That is, 1 can be divided by any number exactly. So every number is a factor of itself and of all its multiples. So every number will be a factor of itself and also its all its multiples. For example, if I take 6, 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, 36, these are all multiples of 6, correct? So 6 is a factor of itself and also it is a factor of 12, 18, 24, 30, 36, okay? So all factors of a number are less than or equal to the number itself. In how in multiples, a multiple of a given number is greater than or equal to the given number. Same way in factors, any factor will be less than the given number or equal to the given number itself. Okay, every number has a fixed number of factors. How multiples are endless or countless, that way factors are not countless. Every number will have a fixed number of factors. Okay, every number except 1 has at least 2 factors. 1 and the number itself. Okay, if a number doesn't have any other factor, it will at least have 1 and the number itself as its factor. Only 1 is a number which has only one factor, which is 1. Okay, or else every other number will have at least 2 factors. So 1 is always the smallest factor and the number itself will be the largest factor. And all the other factors will be between those. Okay, that is between 1 and the number itself. So 1 will be the smallest factor and the number itself is the largest factor. Now coming to common factors. Now how we saw common multiples, same we will see what are common factors. So, okay. So consider the numbers 12 and 16. So we'll factorize both 12 and 16. So how you can write 12? We can write 12 as 1 into 12 or 1 12s are, then 2 into 6 or 3 into 4. So what are the factors here of 12? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. Now we'll write factorize 16. Okay, so 1 into 16, 2 into 8 and 4 into 4. So what are the factors of 16 here? 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. Okay, these are the factors of 12 and factors of 16. So what you can do, you can start with 1 and just see if this given number comes in which table. Okay, so it comes in 1 table, it comes in 2 table, it comes in 3, 4. But does 12 come in 5 table? Is 12 a multiple of 5? No. So it will leave 5 and go to 6. So 6, 2 is 12 again. So 6. Okay, like that you have to write the number as a product of two factors. Now we have all the factors. In this, which are the common factors? 1 is common for 12 and 16. 2 is also common. And 4 is common. No other factors are common. So common factors are 1, 2 and 4. Okay, so among this, which is the highest? 4 is the highest. So here, the highest common factor of 12 and 6 is 4. This is called as HCF. Okay, the highest common factor of a set of numbers is the highest among the common factors of the given numbers. It is also called as greatest common dividers, that is GCD. So it's either HCF or GCD. So the highest among the common factors is the HCF. Alright. So now we'll see a few examples on factors. So here they have to list all the factors of 14 and 35. Circle the common factors and find the HCF. So first we'll list the factors of 14. So to list the factors of 14, first write 14 as 1 into 14. Correct? Then 14 is even. So it is divisible by 2. Since 14 is an even number, it is divisible by 2. So we know that 2 sevens is 14. So 14 is equal to 2 into 7. Now, if it can be written as a product of any pair, or see if it comes in any other table. It doesn't come in any other table. So the factors of 14 are 1, 2, 7 and 14. So you have to write it in ascending order. Then same way, you write the factors for 35. So factors for 35 are 1, 5, 7 and 35. So here we have will circle the common factors. 1 is a common factor and 7 is a common factor. Correct? So common factors are 1 and 7 and HCF of 14 and 35. Now which is the highest among 1 and 7? 7. So HCF is 7. Okay. Now here they've told check if 6 is a factor of 44. So how we'll do that? You can either do it by division. So you can divide 44 by 6. Okay. So when you do that, you'll get a quotient of 7 and a remainder of 2. Since your remainder is 2 here, okay, it is not a factor of 44. If you get the remainder as 0, then 44 would have been a factor of 6. But since the remainder is not 0, 6 is not a factor of 44. So this is one method, that's by division, or you can check by using divisibility rule. So divisibility rule for 6. Now we know that if the given number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then it will be divisible by 6. Now 44 being an even number is divisible by 2, correct? Now to check divisibility by 3, what you will do? You will do sum of digits. So 4 plus 4 is 8, which is not divisible by 3, correct? So 44 is not divisible by 6. Okay, so it is not, 6 is not a factor of 44. So either you can divide, if you get a remainder of 0, then that number will be a factor of it. If it is not, then it is not a factor. Or you can check using the divisibility rules. Alright, so we'll solve a few questions which are given in your textbook. So here exercise 4.2 on page number 142 in your books. So here they've told write, first question is to write all the factors of these given numbers. Okay, so let's do that. So first question A1 is 18. So let's write the factors of 18. So here 18, we know that 1 18 is 18. So we'll write that 1 into 18. Then 2 9 is 18. 18 being an even number, it will be divisible by 2. So 2 9 is 18. Also we know that 3 6 is 18. Then again 6 3 is 18. So it is repeating, right? 3 and 6 and 6 into 3 is the same. So once it starts repeating, you can stop writing the factors. So here we'll write these factors in ascending order now. So we have 1, 2, 3, 6, 9 and 18 as the factors of 18. Okay. Then coming to the next one, 24. So 1 into 24 is 24. Then 2 into 12 is 24. Then 3 8s are 24. 4 6s are 24. Okay. And then 5 it doesn't come. Then 6 4s are 24 again. Correct. So the factors are repeated. So you can stop writing. So here the factors of 24 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12 and 24. Okay, then coming to 26. Now 1 into 26 is 26. 2 into 13 is 26. Then that's all. Okay, then directly you have 13 into 2 as 26. So factors are repeating. So these are the only factors. So what are the factors of 26? We have 1, 2, 13 and 26. Then 15. What are the factors of 15? We have 1 into 15 as 15 and 3 into 5, 15. And 5 threes are 15 again. So the factors of 15 are 1, 3, 5 and 15. Okay. So this was question 1. Now here there are two more questions, E and F, which they have told you to do at home, so do that for homework. Okay, so moving to question 2. Check whether the smaller number is a factor of the bigger in each of these pairs. Okay, first is 14 and 6. You have to check if the smaller number is a factor of the bigger. So what you do, you divide 14 by 6. So when you divide 14 by 6, you'll get a quotient of 2 and a remainder 2. Okay, since the remainder is not 0, 14 is not a factor of 6. Okay, sorry, it should be 16 is not a factor, 6 is not a factor of 14. Okay, so 6 is not a factor of 14. The next one, 28 and 7. So when you divide 28 by 7, you get a quotient of 4 and remainder 0. Since here the remainder is 0, 7 is a factor of 28. Or what you can do is, we don't know, we have not learned divisibility rule for 7. So here you can divide and find out. For 14 and 6, you can also use divisibility rule for 6. That is, if 14 is divisible by both 2 and 3, then it will be divisible by 6 also. 14 being an even number, we know it is divisible by 2. But now, divisible by 3, let's see if the sum of digits is divisible by 3. What are the sum of digits? 1 plus 4, 5. Since 5 is not divisible by 3, okay, 14 will not be divisible by 3. So, 14 is divisible only by 2 and not by 3. So, it is not divisible by 6. Okay, and what you can do is 65, 8 and 20 and 5, you all can try to do for homework on your own. Okay. Now see, I can just give you a hint, 65 and 8. Now for 8, you know that if the hundreds, tens and ones place is divisible by 8, then it will be divisible by 8, correct? So 65, when you divide by 8, you'll get a remainder of 1. So it is not a factor of, so 8 is not a factor of 65. Same with 20 and 5, if you check the divisibility rule, ones place we have 0. So this 20 is divisible by 5, so 5 is a factor of 20. So either you use division method or divisibility rule method and write it like this. If they are divisible, if they are factors of the bigger number or not. So do C and D for homework. Then coming to question 3. You have to list the factors of each of the following pairs and find their HCF. So first is 8 and 12. So what you do, first write the factors of 8. So what are the factors of 8? It is 1, 2, 4 and 8. Then we'll write the factors of 12. So factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. Okay. So here what are the common factors? 1, 2 and 4 are the common factors. And which is the highest among the common factors? It is 4. So HCF is 4. Okay. Then 15 and, so this was the first problem. HCF of 8 and 12 is, and coming to next one, 15 and 25. So first we'll write factors of 15. What are the factors of 15? It is 1, 3, 5 and 15. Then factors of 25 we have as 1, 5 and 25. So which is the common factors among this? It is 1 and 5. And which is the highest common factor? It is 5. So the HCF of 15 and 25 is 5. Next is 9 and 27. So first, we'll write the factors of 9. So 1 9 is a 9 and 3 3 is a 9. So what are the factors? 1, 3 and 9. Then factors of 27 are 1, 3, 9 and 27. So among these, which are the common factors? 1, 3 and 9 are the common factors. So HCF over here is 9. The last problem, 16 and 4. First write the factors of 16. We know 1 into 16 is 16. So 1 and 16 will be factors. 2 8s are 16 and 4 4s are 16. Correct. So the factors of 16 are 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. Then factors of 4. What are the factors of 4? 1, 2 and 4. 1 4s are 4 and 2 2s are 4. The factors will be 1, 2 and 4. So here which are the common factors? The common factors are 1, 2 and 4. So, and the highest among these is 4. So, HCF is 4. Okay. So, this is how you find HCF and this is what is factors. So, for your homework, do these at home questions. That is question 1, E and F, that is over here. Okay. okay, and I gave you to do question 2 C and D also for homework, and question 4, circle the factors of 54. So see which all of these are factors of 54 and circle those numbers. Okay, so complete your homework. In the next class, we will learn what are prime numbers, and then we'll see what are prime factors and prime factorization. Okay, so complete your homework for the next class. Thank you. I'll see you all in the next class. Thank you.